Good morning, everyone. A good tavach. Shavua tov. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. For those of you that are following along inside, you'll note at this point that I'm making a big jump from the last chapter to the chapter that we're moving into right now. For many of the chapters that are in the chronological order, deal with Yom Tov and holidays and festivals, which are not so pertinent at this point. We'll try to learn those halachas maybe as we get closer to the festivals themselves. Chanukah is in there, Purim is in there, Tisha B'Av is in there, Chol HaMoed, Yom Tov, all these halachas that we did not yet get to. I'd like to learn them when it's something more that we're relatable because the holidays are coming up. So I'm going to skip to chapter Simin 152, Kuf Nun Beis, and it's called Isser Yichud Ushar Krevos Benoshim. It's called the Prohibition of Yichud, and we'll discuss what Yichud is, and other prohibited contact with women. Now, we'll see what this is, because this is a halacha that applies to both men and women. We have to help each other out in this case. So in the introduction over here, the Kitzur writes the following idea. And he says that the first part of this simin, which is going to be numbers 1 through 7, there's 17 se'ifim, there are 17 little paragraphs here altogether. So 1 to 7 is going to discuss the prohibition of yichud, which means seclusion. Now, what is seclusion? It means the following. It's prohibited for a man and a woman who are not married to each other to be alone together, since this situation could lead to sin. Obviously, the sin that we're referring to over here is that a man and a woman are going to be intimate with each other. They're not married with one another, and therefore that is a major sin in the eyes of the Torah, in the eyes of Hashem. And this prohibition applies to all people, young or old, regardless of how righteous and upright they might be. Which means the famous story with the Chofetz Chaim, that he was once in the Beis Midrash, and the non-Jewish cleaning lady came into the Beis Midrash to clean, and there was no escape for him to get out of there, because he felt that there was an Isser of Yichud, a prohibition of this seclusion of a man and a woman, and he looked for the escape hatch from the Beis Midrash, and the only way out was to go out a window, which was a second-story window. And the Chofetz Chaim, in order to keep the halacha in the right way, although he was an extremely pious, righteous man, a person should never trust themselves, and therefore what did he do? He jumped out the window, Baruch Hashem, he was unscathed, but he jumped out the window in order to avoid a prohibition of Yichud. Now these things sound to us, in our generation, how could a person do such a thing? Because the overlap of men and women in society is constant, and the breakdown of the walls of the sensitivity to these ideas that men and women need to remain separate in order to guard ourselves from making mistakes seem to be a relic of the past. However, in halach, it's a very serious thing which will affect a person's business, babysitting, doctor's appointments, dating, having guests in your home, renting out a room in your house, and the like. And therefore, it's very important to understand, no matter how big of a tzaddik or a tzaddikis you think that you might be, the laws of yichud apply to you. So he writes further, it's important to note that the laws of yichud are extremely complex, and there are many variables that must be taken into consideration. So as we know, the Kitzur, Shulchan Aruch, is Kitzur, which means that it's the abbreviated form of the Shulchan Aruch. It only sets out the basic halachic parameters of the prohibition, but the circumstances that will affect the halach lemaisa, the ultimate letter of the law over here, they can vary greatly in each and every case. So the circumstances include the nature of the location where you are. It's the time of day or night might be different. Maybe you're driving in a car late at night on a road where nobody else is. That might be a problem of yichud. However, you're driving in a car with a woman that's not your wife during the daytime and there's other cars around, maybe there won't be a problem of yichud. The relationship between the man and the woman, as we'll have to see, there's a difference between a boss and his employee, and then perhaps a person and a granddaughter or something of that nature. We'll have to see, says the Kitzur, and many other factors as well. Therefore, each situation of potential yichud, where you might have the prohibition of seclusion over here, for example, a business or a medical appointment, babysitting, a home service call. Yeah, the woman is home all by herself. Her husband is out of town. The refrigerator breaks and the repairman comes. Are you allowed to be in the house together with that repairman? These are all shilas. Commuting, you're in a carpool, you're going to work, you're going to a chasana, and the only way to get there is with a man and a woman who are not married to each other. Every case has to be evaluated separately and presented to the halachic authority for a ruling. That's the first part of this simin of what we're going to discuss is yichud. And then he writes the second part of the simin of this chapter, which are the paragraphs of 8 to 17. They will discuss the inviolate distance that a man must keep from all women so as to preclude any possibility of sin and to maintain his purity of thought. And we'll get there as well, because again, although perhaps we'll see that the sensitivity has to be truly on the man to be careful in those areas, but we of course require the women's help to make it that we can fulfill these halachas as well. So this is the introduction, and Be'ez Hashem, tomorrow we will begin the si'ifim, the paragraphs over here in chapter 152 in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. Have a wonderful day.